الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم لك الحمد كله ولك الشكر كله وإليك يرجع الأمر كله، علانيته وسره. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد بن عبد الله. The best word ever is the word of Allah. And the best guidance we have it from the word of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brother in Islam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Then in the beginning of khutbah, I recommend you and myself to fear Allah. That is the essential word of every single khutbah. And this is the purpose of every single khutbah. We're going to mention the word of Allah, the word of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All this world working for one goal. What is this goal? To fear Allah. Then what Allah says? Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu ittaqullaha haqqa tuqatih ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to die as a Muslim, to die when you pronounce the Shahada. As the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in Hadith, من كان آخر كلامه من الدنيا لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة. Whoever Allah give him this gift to pronounce the Shahada on the time of death, he will enter the paradise 100% for sure. May Allah Azza wa Jal make all of us like this. And today, inshallah, we're going to focus on one ayah from Surah Al-Mu'minun. Only one ayah. If we understand this ayah good, if we practice this ayah, we will be in the safe side on the dunya and in the hereafter. And this ayah is not the first time in the Quran. It's Allah mentions this story many times. After Allah Azza wa Jal talk about who want to be winner, and everybody will say me, then Allah says قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. In the end of Surah Al-Hajj, when you remember, Allah says, who named us as a Muslim? Who named us Muslimin? Sayyidina Ibrahim. هو سماكم ملة أبيكم إبراهيم هو سماكم المسلمين من قبل. Then after you perfect your Islam, Salah, Siyam, Zakat, Hajj, Shahada, what is the second level? Get ready to be mu'min. You want to be winner? Yes, for sure. Everybody want to be mu'min. Get ready. How I can be mu'min? Read the seven characteristics in the beginning of Surah. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِلزَّكَاةِ فَاعِلُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِفُرُوجِهِمْ حَافِظُونَ إِلَّا عَلَى أَزْوَاجِهِمْ أَوْ مَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ غَيْرُ مَلُومِينَ فَمَنْ يَتَوَلَّ وَرَاءَ ذَلِكَ فَأُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْعَادُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِأَمَانَاتِهِمْ وَعَهْدِهِمْ رَاعُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَى صَلَوَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ أُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْوَارِثُونَ. Then another four characteristics in the middle of surah. 11 characteristics. Inshallah, later on we'll talk about it. إن الذين هم من خشية ربهم مشفقون والذين هم بربهم لا يشركون والذين هم بآيات ربهم يؤمنون والذين يؤتون ما آتوا وقلوبهم وجلة أنهم إلى ربهم راجعون أولئك يسارعون في الخيرات. Those people are very hurry to do the goodness. Allah will bless all of them. Allah will make all of them as a winner. May Allah Azza wa Jalla make all of us and our family and our beloved brothers and sisters as the winners. So this is the surah focused about the mu'mineen. Then Allah talking about the good sign and clear sign, look at around yourself. Look at who created you as something very, very little in your mom's stomach. Then you become bigger and bigger. Then Allah created your body, your bone. Then Allah blow the soul inside your body, start moving. Then after your life, you will die and back to Allah, the creator of you. They are not talking about the ayat Allah sent, Allah created the earth, the heaven, and Allah sent bread for you to feed you. Allah created the animals, you know, to feed you. You're gonna eat from the meat of the animals. You know, not every animal, al-an'am, four kinds. You know that, which is cow, camel, sheep, and goat. This is a four kind. It's a halal meat. Then you're gonna drink the milk. All this ayat, Allah remind you, who did this for you? The creator. The creator. The one who can help you to throw the iman in your heart, if you accept it. Then after all these stories, you need one example. I need one example. When the teacher explains something and the student, they don't understand much, they don't understand perfect, they need example. Give me example for iman. What is the first example Allah mentioned in Surah Al-Mu'minun? Listen to this example.
وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ أَنْ يَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ أَنْ يَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُهُ أَفَلَا تَتَّقُونَ.
Only one ayah. This is the best example for mu'mineen. Who is Noah? One of the most strongest five messengers, one of Ulil Azm ibn al-Rusul, and he's the first prophet ever. Some ulama say Adam was prophet, but Adam didn't went to anybody. But I mean, first messenger. You know the difference between the prophet and the messenger. The prophet, the one who sent him Allah inspiration or some word, but didn't recommend him to deliver this message to the people. This is a prophet. But the messenger is different. Messenger, the one who Allah give him some word, you know, and he recommend him, he order him to deliver for the people. So who is the first Rasul here? Sayyidina Nuh. Prophet Nuh is the first messenger on the earth. You know, what is the first messenger says? What is every messenger says? Is there any difference? No. Every messenger from Allah, they deliver one message. That's why when you understand the meaning of ayah number 19 in Surah Al-Imran, إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. The one religion only you have, Allah send it. Only one religion Allah have sent it to the earth. What is this? Islam. Allah never sent any other religion, name it Christianity or Judaism or whatever. There is no. This is Sharia. And there is a difference between Deen and Sharia. What is the difference? Deen is Aqidah. What do you think about the God? Who is God? That's the Deen. And Sharia is the rule. Do and don't. Halal and haram. Right and wrong. This is Sharia. Some rules, you know, what kind of prayer, how many prayer, how many rak'ah, all of these details. You know, what you do for month of Ramadan, what you do for zakah, for hajj, this is Sharia. Sharia is means the rules of your life, to organize your life. But the deen, what do you think about the God? And who's your God? This is the deen, and big difference between the deen and Sharia. I want to concern you here, every single prophet, they mention the same word. U'budu Allah. Ma lakum min ilahin ghayru. There is no God but Allah. There is no God. Anybody have God can tell me what is this God? Who is this God? What is the proof of his God? Did he announce about himself, I'm a God? There is no God. There is no one announced ever in the humanity historical. No one announced I'm a God. No one. Who says? Did Jesus say I'm a God? There is no any word in the Bible but Jesus say I'm a God. And a lot of millions of people, they worship Jesus as a God. Don't give me proof from the Quran. Give me proof from your Bible, but there is no proof. Give me proof from any other book. Give me any proof. My mind can accept it. Is there any God but Allah? There is no God but Allah. That's the meaning of the deen. And the whole the prophet, they carry the same deen, the same religion. We have one religion only from the heaven, from Allah. What is this religion? اعبدوا الله ما لكم من إله غيره. That's why we repeat every day 17 times at least, إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. You know what the meaning of إياك in Arabic? Only you. He didn't say نعبدك ونستعينك أو ونستعين بك. It's similar in the meaning, but it's not same meaning. Both of them will worship you. But when you say إياك, this pronoun before the verb, that means only you. In Arabic, أسلوب قصر وتخصيص. أسلوب قصر وتخصيص. Only you. We worship only you. And when we need help, we ask only you. This meaning وإياك نستعين. So before the prayer, review what is your troubles, what is your problem in this life, and get report, make report, and ask Allah Azza can solve your problem, because Allah is only the one who can help you to solve your problem. As the meaning of إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. Whole Quran focus about this meaning, and whole Prophet talking about the same word, إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. So Prophet Nuh, the first messenger, he says, اعبدوا الله ما لكم من إله غيره. Worship Allah, you don't have any God but Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. أفلا تتقون, you don't fear Allah? What does mean for this question? If you don't worship Allah, that means you don't fear Allah. You know, you have a troubles, you have a problem in your mind. So we're going to focus about what the meaning of ibadah. In Islam, what the meaning of ibadah? If you translate this word, worshiping, but in Arabic, its meaning is very deep. A meaning, you know, is very, very wonderful meaning. Al-ibadah, اسم لكل ما يحبه الله عز وجل ويرضاه من الأفعال والأقوال. I mean, the worshiping mean, the ibadah mean, name or noun, for every single things Allah love it and Allah accepted and Allah like it from you, from word or action, word or action, even feeling, because we have a biggest, a lot of stuff of ibadah. Some ibadah is body action and heart action and soul action, money action, you know. So for prayer is the heart and soul action with body. Zakat, money action, you know. Hajj, body action, you know, money action as well. Siyam is body action, you know, and soul action. Shahada is the body action because your tongue is repeating ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Soul, mind and heart, everything in shahada. So Allah give you some ibadat to take care of every single part of you. Actually, every human being has a four part. Everybody needs some feeding, some help. Your body, your soul, your heart and your mind. Who is the boss of all of this? Who is the boss? Your heart. Your heart is the boss, is the overhead manager. Your brain, executive manager. Your soul is the power. It's the power of this body. Your soul, if your soul is out, that means you're dead. You should be in the grave in a few hours, a few days. This is the power from Allah. وَنَفَخَ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِهِ. And your heart is exactly, what is the proof? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in hadith, أَلَا إِنَّ فِي الْجَسَدِ مُطْغَى إِذَا صَلُحَتْ صَلُحَ سَائِرُ الْعَمَلِ وَإِذَا فَسَدَتْ فَسَدَ سَائِرُ الْعَمَلِ كُلِّهِ. There is one small part in your body. If it's okay, if it's correct, everybody, every part in your body, every good deeds will be okay, will be acceptable. And if it is corrupted, every good deed will not be acceptable. Everything will be corrupted. Everything will be incorrect, will be invalid. That's why the munafiqeen have, sometimes they have a lot of good deeds. And here, in the hereafter, Allah will not accept anything. Allah will show them the hasanat, the good deeds like a mountain. But Allah says, you make all of these good deeds, not of my sake, for the sake of people. Go to the people that you go, show them, and take your reward from them. That's why they mentioned in Surah Al-Hadid, was talking about this. يوم يقول المنافقون والمنافقات للذين آمنوا انظرونا نقتبس من نوركم. The منافقين المنافقات, men and women, will say to the مؤمنين, look at us, give us some light. We need to go to the Jannah with you. Everything is dark in front of our eyes. Please give us some light. We don't have a light. قيل ارجعوا وراءكم. He didn't say قال المؤمنون, he said قيل. Someone says, back. You cannot be same level as the mu'mineen. فَالْتَمِسُ نُورًا. Back to your bad deeds in the dunya. Back to your bad heart. You know, you didn't make anything for the sake of Allah. Back! And look at the light in the behind. There is no light in the behind. The light in the front of mu'mineen. يَسْعَى نُورٌ بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَبِأَيْمَانِهِمْ. On the right side and on the front of mu'mineen, they walk to the Jannah, everything is light. And the mu'mineen, they look at everywhere, everything is dark. قِيلَ يُنَادُونَمْ أَلَمْ نَكُمْ مَعْكُمْ. We was with you. We pray with you. We did Hajj and Umrah with you. We was spent the month of Ramadan together and prayed Tarawih. We recited Quran with you. He said, yes, sure, you did this. وَلَكِنَّكُمْ بَاتْ فَتَنْتُمْ أَنفُسَكُمْ. You make fitna for your heart. وَتَرَبَّصْتُمْ. You always wish everything bad for the real mu'mineen. وَتَرَبَّصْتُمْ وَرَبْتَبْتُمْ. You have doubt about the Jannah. You had doubt about Iman. You had doubt about Allah. That's why everything is dark in front of your eyes now. Enjoy. You know, enjoy your darkness. So what does the light come from for mu'mineen? Come from ikhlas. Ikhlas means sincere. When you do anything, make sure. Ask yourself, why I'm doing this? I'm doing this for the sake of Allah. That's the meaning of ibadah. We are explaining and focus about the meaning of ibadah. So the ibadah, to make everything that Allah love it, sincerely for the sake of Allah. That's the real conception of ibadah, the real definition of ibadah. If you do something good, but not for the sake of Allah, don't do it. Will not help you much. Will not give you light. You are wasting your time and wasting your money and wasting your effort. That's why Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in many hadith, رُبَّ صَائِمٍ لَمْ يَنَلْ مَنْ صِيَامِهِ إِلَّا الْجُعْ وَالْعَطَشِ. Some of the people do fasting, they never have any reward but hunger and thirsty only. وَرُبَّ قَائِمٍ لَمْ يَنَلْ مِنْ قِيَامِهِ إِلَّا التَّعَبْ وَالنَّصَبْ. And some people do قِيَامُ اللَّيْلِ. But they are not doing this alone in the house, or they do in front of the people. You know, especially, mashallah, in Ramadan gathering meeting, or some people they doing together قِيَامُ اللَّيْلِ. Let's help each other to be a real woman. Let's do قِيَامُ اللَّيْلِ. And, you know, many, many places I see a lot of people, they have a gathering for قِيَامُ اللَّيْلِ. And they recite Quran long time, long prayer, and they cry, okay. What is your feeling? Ask your heart. Are you doing this for the sake of Allah or for showing? That's the meaning of ibadah. That's the real meaning of ibadah. So again, this is the most important to understand. This is the message that Prophet Noah delivered to the people, and that every single prophet delivered to the people. Focus on ibadah. To fear Allah, the ibadah will give education for yourself, for your heart, will raise your iman. We're going to be a real mu'min. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make us real, one of the real mu'mineen. Ameen. So the last question I want to say here, why Allah mentioned the story of Noah. The story of Noah here, Allah mentioned the story of Noah in different 11 surah. Started with Surah Al-A'raf, Surah Yunus, Surah Hud, Surah Al-Anbiya, Surah Al-Mu'minun, Surah Al-Shu'ara, you know, Surah Sad, you know, and Surah Al-Dhariyat, and Surah Al-Tahrim. When Allah mentions any prophet's story, sometimes give you extra details, sometimes give you less. And all the story is matching with the purpose of the surah. And we know, alhamdulillah, what is the purpose of Surah Al-Mu'minun? Allah invites you to be a winner. Allah encourages you, Allah recommends you to be real winner. How? Be a mu'min. What is the example? Prophet Noah is the first example for mu'minin. And the few mu'minin with him was the first best example. That's why Allah mentioned the story in the beginning of the surah, after Allah Azza wa Jalla told us about the characteristics of mu'minin. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه. الحمد لله وكفى وصلاة وسلاما على عباده الذين اصطفى لا سيما الحبيب المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم اجعل آخر كلامنا من الدنيا لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. I just want to tell you some story. We want to practice the meaning of ibadah. You know, we want to practice the characteristics of mu'minin. One of them, والذين في أموالهم حق معلوم. That's mentioned in Surah Al-Ma'arij, not in Surah Al-Mu'minun. So Allah mentioned the same characteristics of musallin and mu'minin, the real mu'minin. The real people who practice the prayer perfect. And how to perfect this? There is characteristics. Allah mentioned in many surah, like وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا and here قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِلَّا الْمُصَلِّينَ in Surah Al-Ma'arij. So one of the characteristics is spend the money for the sake of Allah. And this money is not your option. Some people say, I have option to donate or to spend or not. No, you don't have option. That's not your money. That's the money of Allah. Allah Azza wa Jalla says in Surah Al-Hadith, وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا جَعَلَكُمْ مُسْتَخْلَفِينَ فِيهِ. You are like an attorney for this money, but it's not your. Who give you this money? Allah. Who can take it from you? Allah. Some people are very rich, and on the second day they make a bankruptcy, they don't have any penny. And some people, they was very poor, second day they become rich. That's not much happening, you know, but that's happening. So Allah is controlling the money. Allah is managing the money. When Allah give you money, Allah give you to test you. You have to understand this. So that's why Allah says, وَالَّذِينَ فِي أَمْوَالِهِمْ حَقٌ مَعْلُومٌ. That's very known right. For who? لِلسَّائِلِ. For the one who asks you, وَالْمَحْرُومِ. The people, they don't have money. Today we have a short story. I don't want to take more time because we already almost done. One of the sisters, she is Muslim sister, woman. She was married to a Muslim brother as well. And she was living in his house. Then they fight, like a lot of people, they are fighting. Then he kicked her out. And he put her on the shelter 1.5 years now. There is no any money, there is no any child support, there is no anything for her. He gave her very hard time and very hard punishment. She is out of the house and the shelter like 1.5 years. You know, she has an apartment, she pay like $100,000. And she's working the whole month in Target. She get $1,200. And she spend like, you know, $1,000 for rent, maybe $100 for bills in the small one bedroom. And she has only $100 with $2. So I don't think that's enough for her. She going to some masajid give her $50 or, you know, $100. Some masajid say no, you know, because every masajid now have a problem on the money because of the coronavirus. So we need real support for your Muslim sister. Now she came to the masjid and she cannot have any right from her husband. Not only this, he go to the court, he went to the court, and he gave her a lot of accusation. He wanted to take $2 from her. And it's not enough for him to kick her out with the two little daughter, 4 or 5 years old, you know, and never support her for any penny. This guy, I don't know how these people, how is the kind of these people can say La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. Do you think Allah can accept the jihad from him? This kind of man, they have not any kind of mercy for his kids. Okay, you don't have kind of mercy with your wife because she did a lot of troubles. What about the little kids? What kind of Islam you have? So some people do like this. There is no mercy. And Allah Azza wa Jalla warned us in Surah Al-Talaq, in the divorcing surah, Allah says, لَا تُخْرِجُهُنَّ مِنْ بِيُوتِهِنَّ. Do not kick her out. Never don't do this. Only one reason. If she do adultery with someone else, if she do something haram, only this reason, you kick her out. Because no man can, you know, she don't deserve. But if she was a good Muslim woman, she has a beautiful hijab and she was praying, she made a lot of troubles. Every woman make a lot of troubles. And every man sometimes a troublemaker. We don't accuse anybody. So how kind of mercy they have? So we really need support for this sister. You know, please put it on the box of the masjid expenses. Where is this box, please? The masjid, not any box, masjid expenses. You know, inshallah, we're gonna see this box, yeah. Inshallah, put it here. Only support on this, we wanna gather this money only for this sister, not for the masjid, not for anything. I was talking to the sheikh, you know, we need to put one box for the masjid, one box. He said, no, this is priority to support. She went to the lawyer to try to get her right. The lawyer told her $5,000. And she doesn't have any pain. You know, so please support for your Muslim sister. When you do this help, Allah will help you when you have troubles. You know, and one of the, I'm not sure this is hadith sahih or no, but this is the correct word. صَنَاعِ الْمَعْرُوفِ تَقِي مَصَارِعَ السُّوءِ. When you do something good for hard time, to remove the hard time for some people, Allah will be with you in the hard time that you will have in one day. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا. اللهم عافنا واعف عنا. اللهم تجاوز عن سيئاتنا. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها. أنت وليها ومولاها. اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا بما فعل السفهاء منا. اللهم لا تؤاخذنا بما فعل السفهاء منا. اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا. اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا. اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية في الدين والدنيا والآخرة. اللهم إنا نسألك إيمانا لا يرتد أبدا ويقينا لا ينفد ومرافقة نبيك محمد في الجنة. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الرحمن الرحيم. مالك يوم الدين. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أرأيت الذي يكذب بالدين فذلك الذي يدع
اليتيم ولا يحض على طعام المسكين فويل للمصلين الذين هم عن صلاتهم ساهون الذين هم يراءون ويمنعون الماعون. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.